For the very first time on the channel, we're going to be doing a submarine build. Well, actually, this video is going to have two entire submarine builds because these kits are awesome. They were sent over by Atlantis. These are available right now. I'm going to be building the USS GATO and the USS Nautilus. Now, I'm not going to be building the actual GATO. I'm going to be building one of the submarines you can do in the GATO class of submarines. The kit actually has the decals available for the drum, silver sides, croaker, cod, cobia, cavala, and the GATO. Awesome decal sheet. In that, you can make numerous other submarines. It's got the white numbering. It's got white, very small numbering. It's got some nameplates. And then it's got the shadowed numbers on that decal sheet. And Atlantis decal sheets are absolutely outstanding. We're going to put the Nautilus back there. We're going to take a look at that. This bad boy is 1/240th scale. They made them in box scale back in the day, so that they would fit inside certain size boxes to fit on retailer shelves, instead of nowadays where you have like 1/700th, 1/350th. These Atlantis kits are vintage reissues of original kits. They're not supposed to be the world's most accurate models. They're supposed to be quick building, fun, nostalgic, vintage retro awesomeness, and that's what Atlantis excels at. Made in the USA, their kits are. The instruction manuals are even reprints of the vintage. Gives you some details about the submarine kit. Even includes the one that I'm going to be doing, the USS Cobia 245 in Manitowoc, Wisconsin. I've actually had the chance to walk inside that submarine, feel it move in the bay where it is, the waves coming off Lake Michigan. The instruction sheets on these don't get much more simple than that. These should be very easy builds. They've come with stands and everything. Let's look at what's in the GATO, and then we will take out what is in the Nautilus. First up, the giant hull. Now, you saw the decals, of course. We're not going to show those again. Look at how nicely molded that is, all in black, to make your life a lot easier. Now, since it's a ship, I'm going to be priming in black anyways so that the other paints will adhere. But if you want to build it as is, this is pretty easy. I'm going to do my GATO, or my Cobia, GATO class, as it sits in Manitowoc. Not when it was on patrol, not any specific date. I'm going to do it as they painted it up, as it sits in the harbor in Manitowoc, floating for a museum. We got the nice decks here, which look just like the ones that are on the real one that I walked on. And in fact, they are this color. They're this black, high grip, over the wood deck. They paint this high grip textured material, almost like bed coating all over them. We got the fins here. We got part of the tower. So more than enough detail in this scale to appease. We got all the little periscopes and antennas. We've got deck guns. There should be one here. It was in the bag. I've got it on the side, but it is identical. We've even got little cleats in there. A nice stand that just says Fleet Submarine. Got some railings, some prop shafts, we got our propellers, we got other little small pieces there, and it looks like we've got some fins. So nice detail, more than enough detail to get this thing painted up and decorated. That is it. That's all that's in the box. These builds won't take long. We're going to come right back. I'm going to unbox the Nautilus. And now to unbox the Nautilus, because I'm going to build them both, one right after the other, and then come back, show them both off in sub-assemblies, get them into paint, detail them up together. 1/300th scale, the USS Nautilus nuclear submarine. It ends up being 12 inches long. The GATO class will be 15.5 inches long, because it's a little bit of a larger scale. Excellent looking submarine. Of course, submarines don't have a ton of stuff on the outside of them, especially the modern ones. They want them to be more stealthy. So we will take a look at everything that's in the box. This is for building the Nautilus itself. I don't think there's anything in there to build anything else. Gives a nice history on there. And then we have that nice standard assembly. Super easy assembly. Got our stand with it and everything. The Nautilus also includes this cool little booklet. Teaches kids and you, I mean, there's always something, I'm going to read this when I'm done making the model, but how they work, how it went underneath the North Pole, and all of this stuff. I have a great uncle that claims he was on this submarine, and I don't know how to find the register list of all the men that were on the ship when it went underneath the North Pole. And I don't really want to look because I like the story, but he was in the submarines. He lived in Groton, Connecticut, and he was on a lot of the first submarines. So I'll have to look it up someday to see if my Uncle Dougie was actually on that ship. We've got a small set of decals here. They're all in white. They will replicate what you see in the box art here. They really are hard to come on the camera, but you can see we've got some reflections there. We got the 571, we've got some callouts and EAE, we've got some small numbers here. The word Nautilus is on there twice, so those are a little hard to see, but they'll look good. We have a clear part, which I did not expect. Don't lose that, that's loose in the bag, so that must go into the tower or something for some open glass portholes that they could see through. On this side, molded in an off black, are our decks, the stand, which says USS Nautilus on it, nice and broad. We've got fins, we've got towers, we've got what looks like a deck gun, and a drone or a rocket of some sort. I mean, it definitely looks like it flies, whatever it is. I'll have to see that in the manual. And we got the other fins in there. We got the propellers. We've got part of the tower right there. And we've got the hull, about 12 inches long. I pushed it together by hand. Just so you can see, Atlantis has been paying attention to the molds. You're not going to have any warp issues with this one. Haven't tried it with the Cobia, the GATO class yet. But this looks like it fits quite nicely. I'm not going to be filling anything. I build them as they are. And that is it. That's all the parts. Submarines don't need a lot of things. They're a fun build. I'm going to get to gluing these two together, and I'll be right back. Well, like I said, submarines don't take all that much to put together when they're this size, unless you get one of those giant, like, 4-foot, you know, wooden models or whatever. I didn't think I'd have much of a problem, and I didn't. And Atlantis has taken care of the molds to the point where there really was no seam work to do because of the way the decks are going to go on and everything. And now you can see that these build into two very nice size models, nice size shelf models. They'll fit behind other kits if you like to display all your stuff. And they're not so small that you're not going to see a lot of the cool details. So for both, I have parts that I'm going to be painting off the model and parts that I'll be painting on the model. We got the decks of the Nautilus here. Those will be painted separately off the side of the model. We got the propellers for the Nautilus, and I cut the trees so that I can get stuff painted on separately. We've got the deck gun for the Nautilus. We've got all the different antenna and equipment, and that is a missile, according to the directions. That is a missile that can be fired off, so that will all be placed on the deck. That is all set on its own little trees. We've got the props for the Cobia. We've got all the deck guns for the Cobia. I ended up cutting them off just to see how nicely they fit. Then I'll stick them to some poster tack and get them painted up separately and then attach them to the deck with super glue later. So we'll look at the boat I'm going to make into the Cobia. You can see the con tower and everything is a separate piece. We can get that painted in the base color for the top of the ship because, like I said, I'm doing this as it is docked in Manitowoc, and then I can get the deck color hand painted on that tower there and get all those arranged the way I like it. We can detach it from its base, take the decks off. You can see the hull itself. I've got the dive planes attached, front and rear. Got the propeller guards. The propeller guards are those little wire things, or I thought they were railings. They're propeller guards, and they are in the real thing. Got the propeller shafts installed on the bottom, and got the rudder and the fins installed. You'll notice that the model glue will lighten up the plastic. There were some areas where I ended up getting a thumbprint in it by accident, so that's where you'll see the sanding marks. I'm not really worried about the seam. And I've attached the stands to the bottom so that I have something to hold on to when I paint, and then I can just go over those stands with hand-painted black paint later. And then it will attach to the stand itself, but you can see the hull's a beautiful shape. You can see there's no real giant gaps in the hull to worry about. And it is a nice size model that will secure to the base lovely. I will secure it in place once I'm done, and then I will super glue it. The decks mount on beautifully without issue. Those will be super glued down when I'm ready towards the end, but I want those painted separately from the ship. You can see that it even has capstans on the front and all the little tiny, I gotta wait for this thing to focus in because it's very close. Put the hand back there. You can see all the little cleats that go along the decks so they can tie it off. So that's a nice amount of detail on the GATO class, the Cobia that I'm doing, and that one is ready for paint. Then we get to the Nautilus. Well, the Nautilus is a lot smoother. There's a lot less stuff on the decks. There's a lot of less stuff going on because these were faster. They could dive longer. They didn't have to keep coming up like the World War II subs do. We've got the fins attached. Now on those, the prop shafts are built into the rear fins, so the props will be attached back here. And then we've got the other rear fins attached. I've got the stand glued into this one as well. Now that clear window on the front, it says right in the directions, feel free to paint over that. Looking at pictures of it, I didn't see anything that looked like that, so I'm just going to paint over it. We got our front dive planes attached. Those even have little mock hydraulics attached to raise and lower them. So I thought that was a cool little detail. But otherwise, the hull goes together nicely. There's a little bit of a gap on the bottom, but again, it's on the bottom. It will sit on the stand like so, so you're not really going to see it. The nose is closed, the tail is closed, and the top seals up nicely and will have decks on it anyways. So I didn't really worry about that on the bottom. If you want to fill that in, you can see it's just a little bit of a gap highlighted by a good amount of glue. If you choose to fill that in, good for you. It's your model. You build it as you please. Mine's going to be sitting like that its entire life. It's going to be glued to a stand, so I'm not going to worry about it at all. I'm going to get all these parts over to paint. There is some two-tone painting needed. There are some different shades of paint needed. It won't all be black or all gray. So I will get over there. We'll throw some paint at everything right now. And with that, I am done with the first two submarine builds. Yes, when I introduced these on the new kits video this past weekend, I was like, well, I'm gonna build one, and then the other one we're gonna just unbox. I opened up the boxes, did that, and I saw that they wouldn't be difficult at all to build and that would be able to detail them. And I liked the looks of them, and the hulls went together so easy, and there was no rubber banding or all this other kind of work that I thought would need to make these fit together like there is with so many other subs, that I decided to build both. And I'm glad I did, because now I have a model of the Cobia and I have a model of the Nautilus for my first two modern submarines. Now Atlantis also is going to be releasing the Merrimack and Monitor, and I only know that because I follow them on Facebook. I have no insider industry information. I know a lot of you ask me that. Well, what are they doing this and who's doing that? And I don't know until they tell everyone, and then I find out. So they're going to be releasing those. So those will be actually the two earliest type of submarine or armored ship warfare. But here we've got World War II tech, and we've got post-World War II tech, the nuclear subs that came out, with somewhat of a family connection and a state connection, because this is sitting in Manitowoc and this is in Connecticut, and my great uncle Dougie claims to have been on the Nautilus, so that's pretty cool with those connections. The kits build up super easy. Anyone could build these right out of the box. Someone with absolutely no model experience could open these up and build them as they are with model glue and some super glue if they needed to attach the final parts, if they wanted to build it like I did, paint them separately, and have a really nice time doing so. Or if you want to build them like I did and take them a little bit farther, do minimal weathering, because I did mine as they're sitting in their museum states right now, with the way they look in pictures that I could find, with a little bit of fading and a little bit of algae, but in otherwise in excellent shape, so that people can climb on them. I got to walk the full deck on the Cobia, go down inside, take the tour inside, and enjoy all that and see all the stuff. Never been on the Nautilus. I've seen it when I was younger and we traveled out there. I could see it in the port, but we didn't go that. The people I went with weren't into going to museums or stopping at stuff like that. But anyways, thanks to Atlantis for sending these over. These are available right now. I will link down in the description where you can snag up both. I highly recommend them if you are into any sort of sea craft, submarines, World War II, post-World War II technology, anything cool like that. These will make some pretty cool displays, especially as the first submarines. I do plan on building that Monitor and Merrimack. I actually have a vintage version of that kit from Lindbergh. Now that Atlantis is going to be issuing it, I'm definitely going to want to build it up. I'm also going to go outside in this beautiful fall weather we've been having this week and read up the little pamphlet that comes with the Nautilus. And I hope you will too, to have a little fun, learn a little bit, and enjoy yourself. As always, thanks to Atlantis Models for sponsoring these kits on the channel. We always appreciate their support, and they do nothing but release retro awesome sauce goodness, and I've got more of that coming on the show. Thanks to you for all your kind comments, your likes, your shares, and in knowing how to enjoy the hobby. Smile, have fun, build for you, and remember that it's just a hobby. We'll see all of you at the next review.